Hello everyone, welcome back to Faceless Mindset. In today's lesson, we are going to learn how to solve for the length of any right angle triangle using the Pythagorean Theorem. I have three problems, and in the first problem, we are going to learn how to find the hypotenuse of a right triangle. And in the other two problems, we are going to solve problems on finding the length of the two legs of a right triangle. Just a quick review about what a right triangle is. A right triangle is a triangle that has three sides. In this case, we have side A, side B, and side C. These two sides, A and B, are called the legs of the triangle. Because they are perpendicular to each other, they form an angle of 90 degrees, which is the right triangle. And then we have the side C, which is called the hypotenuse. These three sides are related to each other using the Pythagorean theorem. So the Pythagorean theorem says, the sum of the squares of the two legs, that is A squared plus B squared, is always equal to C squared. And this only applies to right triangles. And in this case, we can use the Pythagorean theorem, as we are going to see shortly in the three problems I have for you. How to find the length of these three sides in a problem. Get your notebooks and let's get started. In the first problem, it says a right triangle has legs of length 6 meters. So the first leg has a length of 6 meters. And the second leg has a length of 8 meters. And we are asked to find the hypotenuse, which is the side C, which is the longest side of the right triangle. Down here we can see we have our first leg having length 6 meters, and then the second leg having length 8 meters. And to solve such a problem, all we need to use is the Pythagorean theorem, because this is a right triangle and we are given the length of the two legs and we are asked to find the length of the hypotenuse, which is side C. And to do so, I'll first take the data. So let's look at the solution. So to solve this problem, I'll take the data. So given A as 6 meters, B as 8 meters, and then C, we are to find what C is. We can only do this on this right triangle by applying the Pythagorean theorem, which says that A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared. Now we can plug in our values and then compute for the value of C. So we can rearrange this equation such that our C is on the left-hand side, so it is going to be C squared equals A squared plus B squared. So C squared is going to be equal to, what is A? We plug in the value of A. So for now, I'll go 6 meters all squared plus B squared. So what is the value of B, which is 8 meters all squared? Now we can write C squared. So 6 squared is 6 times 6, and the meter squared is m times m, so that is m squared. So 6 times 6 is 36. So that gives us 36 meters squared plus 8 times 8 is 64. And then we have meters squared. So in this case, we can add these two terms on the right-hand side because they are all the same terms, right? We have 36 m squared plus 64 m squared, so we can add them comfortably. So c squared would be equal to 100 meters squared, right? Now we want c, not c squared. So to do that, we have to take the square root of both sides of the equation, right? So here the square root will take the squared on C, leaving C stand alone as the square root of 100 meters squared. In this case, the square root would take the square on the meters, and then the square root of 100 is 10. So C is going to be equal to 10 meters. So that is the end of the problem. We are to find the length of the hypotenuse side C, and we have found it to be 10 meters. Good job. Now let's look at the second problem in finding the leg. So let's read the problem. We can see the orientation of the triangle in this case is different from the first one. It doesn't change anything. All you need to do is identify the two legs, which are always perpendicular to each other, and then the hypotenuse, that is the side, which is opposite to the right angle. And also, the hypotenuse is the longest side of the right triangle. Now let's read the problem. The problem says a right triangle has hypotenuse of 13 inches and one leg of 5 inches. Find the length of the other leg, A. So we are given a problem where we know the value or the length of the hypotenuse. We know the length of one of the legs. Then we are to find the length of the other leg, the missing leg. All right. So as usual, let's look at the solution. So I'll first take the data from the problem, which I always encourage my students to do that because it helps you state all the information known from the problem and what is unknown from the problem, so it can guide you into finding exactly what you are looking for. So here we are given the side A as an unknown. That is what we are going to find. That is the task for this problem. We are given the side B as 5 inches. So inches, I'll just do IN. Okay. And then we are given side C, which is the hypotenuse, as 13 inches, right? So we use the Pythagorean theorem, okay? Which is A squared plus B squared equals C squared, all right? The rest of the problem is plugging in these values and finding the leg A, the length of the leg A. So this is the missing part we are looking for. All right. So we have A squared plus B squared. What is B squared? So into bracket, we have 5 inches squared. And that is equal to C squared, which is into bracket 13 inches squared. So A squared plus 5 squared is 25, inches squared is inch squared, then equals 13 squared would give us 169 squared. So 169 inches squared. Okay. Now we can see a squared and 25 inches squared are on the left hand side. So we can move 25 to cross the equal sign to the right hand side. And in doing so, we are going to have a squared equals 169 inches squared minus 25 inches squared. So we can subtract 25 from 169. So we will have a squared to be equal to 144 inches squared. That's the unit, right? So we want to isolate a, not we don't want a squared. So we have to take the square root of both sides, which will leave a equals the square root of 144 inches squared. In this case, a is just going to be 12 inches. Okay. Yes. Now we have also been able, through applying the Pythagorean theorem, to find the length of the other leg, okay, given the length of one leg and also the hypotenuse. Now let's look at the last problem, which is very similar to this one because we have two legs, which would be always the same way in finding them. All right, so let's look at the next problem. The problem reads, find the length of side B in the given right triangle. So we are given a right triangle, which looks like this in this case. All right. So we can clearly see the 90 degree angle is here. All right. So these two sides are our legs. They are perpendicular to each other, forming an angle of 90 degrees. And then opposite to this 90 degree angle, we have the hypotenuse. So let's look at the solution. So the solution, let's take the data. So we are given A equals 25 centimeters. We are given B equals our unknown. And then the hypotenuse equals 103 centimeters, right? What do we use? The tool to use for solving this problem is the Pythagorean theorem. So we use Pythagorean theorem, which says A squared plus B squared is equal to C squared, all right? So we can plug in our values and then determine what B is. So A squared is going to be 25 centimeters squared plus B squared equals 103 centimeters all squared. So 25 squared is going to be 625 centimeters squared plus B squared equals 103 centimeters squared is going to be 10,609 centimeters squared, right? So we want to isolate B. So B, we can do so by just moving 625 centimeters squared over to the right hand side. So if we do that, it is going to subtract from what is already on the right-hand side. So we are going to have B squared equals 10,609 centimeters squared minus 625 centimeters squared. So this will give us B squared equals 9,984 centimeters squared. Therefore, B would be square root of 9,984 centimeters squared, right? So evaluating this is going to give us about 99.92 centimeters. All right. So that's all for this video today. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe to the channel. That's the least way you could support me. Like and share, and let's spread the word. Take care. See you in the next video.